crisis rages across continents and the headlines. The day treads as though finds the world brand new and limitless, and made especially for him. Dave, keep up. Dave says the early morning suits me best, since it's just me and Dave. I take the compliment blushingly. Absurd to have so much news when the world is too big to report, and everything in it and everything we're made of flutters minutely. Early in the morning, no one is anything but small. Stepping out along the rutted terrain, the air thickens and toughens. An electric wind is crossing the land. This looks like a planet, I say to no one in particular. A planet made of everything humans were made of, left to swirl for all time, while drops of relief collect on the webs and boughs as the clocks crumble in the rising sun and scatter on the breeze. The time before and the time after. Oh, hello. I suppose you saw all this coming. Please, Your Honor, what is the name of this country or planet or cosmos? Where's Dave? How do I get back? Or is that the wrong question? Should I change my mind or change my direction? What's through here? And over there, and what is the difference? Will I live a long life, or medium to short life, or... Too many lives to mention. What next? Which way? Why not all of you? What's the good of latitude or longitude, magnitude or infinitude, when the further one goes, the less one knows of distance? Is this the way home? Gouging up the next underground extension is no small feat of coordination. The longer the passage, the taller the scrap heap shooting up behind you. It's a house, really a massive house, a minuscule house. One room, many chambers, all open plan and made entirely of offcuts. Still, it fits the family, and it has a door. The door inwards is the door to the other side. Passing through it is a form of relief. Of all the possible feelings, relief has always been a favorite. From that hole of an apartment, a vista emerges. A field, a country, a universe. Actually, it's pretty pleasant around here, Dave. The scenery's decked out in light rays and mellow shadows. When I arrived, all the inhabitants stood up to greet me, and the trees, the real trees, came closer as they yawned and lengthened. They gathered, let me hide between their legs, took me under their wings, parentally. Wish you were here.
Look into my eyes. Look into my eyes.
Look deep into my eyes. You will begin to feel awakened. Very, very awakened. Oh, look. It's beginning to moon, and it will moon, and it has mooned a long time, ever since the moon was a spike of cold, silver whisker.